right, guys, we're ready to go. So tonight's movie is going to be The Terror. It's got Roger Corman. It's got Jack Nicholson way back in the day. This was, like, even before The Shining, like, long before The Shining. So this will be kind of fun to watch. So, again, this is our marathon of movies, a new horror movie, old classic horror movie every night, all the way up until Halloween. And away we go. Did I mix up the movies again? Oh, Jack Nicholson, okay. It's not Roger Corman, right?
I don't know.
I'm so confused. Boris Karloff. Boris Karloff, Lon Chaney Jr., and who's the other one? Like, those two are, like, the masterpieces. Well, he was just kind of a different one, though. He wasn't really horror movies. Associate producer, Francis Ford Coppola. I didn't even know that. That's awesome. That's crazy. over on YouTube that have been watching since the start. And the people on Twitch, I see you guys.
Hello!
And on Rumble.
Hello! Do you know the road to Colden? I was separated from my regiment at Arshot. You have any drinking water? I'm very thirsty.
Thank you. Bye. Ba ba ba.
That's it. attack me. I'm afraid you're wrong. She's quite harmless.
Wait, it says I have two confirmed viewers, but he was only tracking one of them.
Hold on, Sarah. She only seems dangerous. Actually, she's very affectionate, which is very unusual for a girl. She's back. Oh, that is too bad. Little girl liked him, didn't you? This is Gustav. We brought you here. Gustav fed your horse.
Where is Helene?
This is Helene.
No, not the bird, the girl. Where is the girl?
There is no girl.
Of course there's a girl. I saw her. She spoke to me.
Perhaps you were tired from your long journey and had a pleasant illusion. Gustav, have you ever seen a girl here? Gustav sometimes imagines things. If he could speak, I think he would find that his mind is warped. Such is the will of God, to endow and deprive. Only thing of beauty to find in this forest is Helene.
You'd drown. So you are real. I started to think. Who are you?
The fire.
Roxanne.
The girl was trying to kill me.
She knows not what she does. Her will is not her own.
You mean she's insane?
Possessed. She needs your help.
Help?
Why
how can
insane?
I help her?
He can't talk.
The castle of the Baron von Webb. You will find her there. I can say no more. There's great danger. Find Eric. Eric knows.
Show me where the castle of the Baron von Lepp is.
No one's lived in the castle for years. And besides, Gustav has gone away for a few days.
Perhaps you'd show me the way to the castle.
Why are you so interested in the Baron?
I never said that I was, but the girl that I followed last night and spoke to, I believe that she lives there.
Told you. There is no girl.
That is nonsense. You recognize her, don't you?
No.
It just happens to be
that. I'll find the castle myself.
No, wait!
I've seen the uniforms of many governments in my time. What would
a soldier of France you wanted here?
Shelter, for one thing. Permit me to introduce myself, Lieutenant André Duvalier, 5th Chasseur.
Baron Victor Frederick Bonlet. I suggest you will find better shelter at the village inn.
Thank you, Baron, but I've had my fill of village inns. Surely you wouldn't want to inconvenience a French officer.
Come in. What do you see, Lieutenant? The remains of a noble house. Relics. Ghosts of past glory.
A noble heritage is something to be proud of, Baron. I'm afraid we've forgotten that in France.
Ah, yes.
Your name, Duvalier. Your family.
My father was the Comte de Valier. Was until they spilled his head into a basket one morning in the Place de la Concorde.
Forgive me for reviving painful memories.
You must be cold and tired, Lieutenant.
Some cognac?
I'd like that, Baron. Thank you.
Sit down.
Stefan?
Yes, Baron.
Cognac for our guest.
Yes, Baron.
Baron, I wonder if I might ask, who was the young woman I saw in the window before you came to the door?
Young woman? Oh, I'm afraid you're mistaken.
No, I'm not mistaken. I saw her. Dark hair and eyes, about 20.
Well, I'm quite sure you think you saw someone, but...
Baron, I am in full possession of my faculties.
Please. Allow me to show you something. You should never believe everything your eyes tell you, young man. Is that the girl you think you saw?
Yes, of course.
Before you say anything else, examine the portrait closely, the signature, and above all, the date.
But that's 20 years ago. It's incredible. It's the same girl and she hasn't changed a bit.
She has been dead for 20 years.
With all respect, Baron, for a ghost, she's a very active young woman.
You're speaking of the Baroness von Lett, my wife.
I beg your pardon, Baron. I meant no offense. Perhaps the resemblance was not quite as much as I had thought. The girl at the window...
Lieutenant Duvalier, the only occupants of this castle are Stefan and myself. You were the first visitor since the turn of the century.
Of course, Baron.
Stefan will see you to your room.
Thank you.
Saw her, didn't she try to kill him? Yeah.
That was actually two times that she tried to kill him, so...
door, I'm going to shoot through the door.
Strange one, though. He showed no fear.
Well, he was leaving what?
You think perhaps he's not merely a trapper?
Why do you say that?
He might have heard things in the village.
Oh, nonsense. He's a soldier. He doesn't listen to all wise things. The important thing is to believe with all due speed.
I shall see him, sir.
But of his own accord. He was showing the respect position and rank demand. Outward man.
I understand, sir. Thank you.
Lugosi. Lon Chaney.
So,
Bela Lugosi.
If I intrude, Stefan, I shall leave it to my host to self-inform me. Why do you come to Castle Bonnet? What do you want here? You seem to have things strangely confused in your mind. You're the servant, not I. I'll ask the question. Since once a place of worship, why are the holy objects been removed?
The Baron ordered. When his wife, the Baroness Elsa, passed away.
Then this became her tomb?
No, just the entrance to it. The Von Lepp family crypt lies below, beneath the cemetery. She rests there with 4 centuries of Von Lepps. That's been sealed for 20 years.
Nonsense. Must have been open last night. The girl must have passed through here.
As the Baron told you, sir, there is no girl.
No girl. Well, we shall see. Come with me to the stable, Seth, and I wish you to attend to my horse.
Wait a minute. That's what I came to tell you. Your horse is gone. Apparently it bolted during the night.
Impossible. You're lying. Why?
No, sir, I'm not lying.
Hear me well, Seth. I'm sick of all of these lies. First the old woman, then the Baron, and now you.
The old woman?
You mean, never mind. What about my horse?
I shall get you another one from the village at once, sir. We mean, Lieutenant, I have no desire to interfere with your departure from this castle.
You seem very anxious to be rid of me. Is it because you're afraid I might find out about Eric?
Eric?
So there is an Eric. That, at least, was not a lie.
Lieutenant, please, don't involve yourself in these dead matters. There is nothing here but an old man and his decaying memories. I beg of you, leave him in peace.
Will you join me, Lieutenant?
No, thank you, Baron. I've just come from the stable. My horse is gone.
Your horse is gone?
Yes, I believe it was stolen.
Oh, impossible.
The stable door perhaps was left open to the animal bolted. It's not an unusual thing.
In itself, no. But there are certain other mysteries I would like to have explained, Baron, and I mean to have them explained.
How dare you take that tone with me?
I don't mean to be abrupt, but I will have answers.
Well?
Now, why did you remove the portrait of the Baron's from the wall?
Why, it's in way for renovation. The dampness of these walls puts a mold on the pigment.
You evade very cleverly, Baron. Can you also explain the violin music and the girl in the chapel last night?
You saw her again.
So you admit there's a girl?
Ilsa.
Ilsa, is that her name? Answer me, Baron.
Please, please, leave me in peace.
If I leave you now, Baron, I will come back with a company of my men, and I will tear this place down around your ears until I find her. Is that clear?
Very clear.
All right, now what happened to the Baron? Was her death violent?
Yes, her death was violent.
How did she die?
You spare me nothing. 20 years ago, I was not the man you're looking at now. This land, this estate prospered. My people lived well and were happy. My wife had died some years before, and I was lonely. And one day, in the village, I saw Ilsa, a peasant girl who'd come to live there with her mother. Oh, I could have taken her. No fools have taken their daughters, peasants, since the beginning of time. I loved her. She became the Baroness von Lepp. Almost immediately afterwards, I was called away for military service. Rebellion in Napoleon Parliament. I was gone for nearly a year when the fighting was over. I hurried home. To my surprise, no one knew of my coming. I surprised her in her home. She was not alone. She laughed at me, said her bed was find another. With my own hand, I killed her.
And her lover?
You killed her for cheating.
Later, I gave out a story that she had died. Some malaise. No one ever knew of her betrayal of me. Oh, in fact, she did die.
Except for Stefan.
spirit been coming to the castle?
It all began 2 years ago. The first time I was terrified, but now I'm eager for our every meeting.
One more question, Baron. Has anyone else except yourself seen the spirit? Stefan, for instance.
You think I'm mad, don't you?
Right now, Baron, I'm not sure just what I think.
Ah, but don't forget, you saw her too. Perhaps we're both mad.
Question about the break. I'm the one who should be doing the asking. I'm invited in, of course. that is forbidden for any of the villagers to set foot here, much less make it their home. How long have you been living here?
Only 2 months.
Perhaps I should tell you. You see, I've just come from Kleinschmidt. We were not totally unknown. You've lived here slightly more than 2 years. Your name is Katerina. You originally come from Kolin, where you were quite unpopular because of certain activities. They called you Katerina the Heretic, the Witch.
They were fools.
Why do you live here? What do you want?
I haven't any money. This was the only place that wasn't burned to the ground, so I brought my things in here.
Where did you find a girl?
Is no girl.
I saw her. She was sitting in this chair.
There is no girl.
I know what she is. Old woman, I know what she is. Listen to me and listen to me very carefully. I don't know what you want, or do I fully understand your black abilities? But if the two of you have not returned to Kolin within one night, I shall come back here and kill you with my own hands and burn this place to the ground once and for all.
And you know who was sent here all those years ago?
You know who lived here.
Eric.
I bet that was the lover.
Attention, Bob.
No.
Hello?
He now refuses to leave. I don't think he will leave of his own accord.
He must. I gave you definite orders.
Barry, you would know this officer is here. If he should never arrive in Copeland.
Are you suggesting that
it's the only way?
That I will never countenance.
God knows I have enough upon my conscience without the senseless murder of a young man who never harmed me.
How do you know what Harney plans? You want him wandering around the castle? You want him down in the crypt?
Enough. The crypt is no concern of yours.
Thank you.
think since they're supposed to be, like, in France, they'd have, like, French accents or something. I think Boris Karloff would be able to pull off a French accent. Maybe Jack Boy can't. I think you should just be letting it go. The guy's been in self-imposed imprisonment
for
20 years, stuck with the ghost of his wife.
Yeah. What is the meaning of this intrusion?
I'm sorry, Baron. I thought I heard voices.
Does that give you the right to burst into my room unannounced? I beg your pardon, Baron. Stefan has gone to the village to another horse. It will save us both embarrassment if he will leave the moment you return.
There can be no doubt of it, sir.
Thank you.
this girl.
She's seen you. She loves you. You must help her. Tonight, her soul cries out for release. Go back.
I've been searching for you, to help you, but you wander in strange places at strange hours.
You're really here.
Of course I'm here, and I'll never leave you again.
Never. When the night comes, I get cold. My arms and my shoulders get cold. I don't like the night. I want to be free of it.
You are free.
And the computer makes a cool print on the door.
In this holy place.
No. Everywhere with me. You must come away with me now.
No, I can't. Not until...
Until what?
The crypt. It must be destroyed. And with it, the dead.
Don't speak of the dead anymore. You're with me now.
I am possessed of the dead.
You're a warm living woman. Who has told you these things?
The dead.
In Paris, they're doing wonderful things to discover the nature of the mind. I'll take you there. There are doctors who can free you from this.
From the dead.
The dead cannot reach out from the grave. You must come away with me now.
No. I'm afraid. The night.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Thank you.
Ilsa, my love. You are not alone. I am here with you. Soon I will join you in eternal sleep. Stefan will flood the crypt and see us here together with our love. Elsa, why do you not talk to me?
I am here. I've been waiting for you.
My love.
You know what you must do.
Anything I will do, the bad I dare not do, not ask me, I beg of you.
You must, or we can never be together.
No, I cannot, I dare not.
Look at me, Victor.
Elsa, why do you torment me so?
Doctor in the village?
His illness is not of the flesh. I've seen this before, and a day until his mind will return. We can only wait.
The Baron tells me you've been with him since the Polish campaign.
That is true.
Then you must have been in this castle for 20 years. You must know every section of the estate. He's regaining consciousness.
No. He often moans during these seizures.
You have keys. Fetch them. I'd like to see the chapel.
The chapel?
Yes, if you don't mind. Do you have a crowbar?
Yes, come with me.
What is it?
That light there. That's the Baroness's bedroom in the tower. Room's been sealed ever since that night. I mean, the Baron would enter.
Come with me.
I'm not buying that.
The Baron should find out we've entered this room.
child?
I don't know. I never thought she did.
You spare me nothing.
Baron, if you'll permit me, I think that I can explain.
Stephanie,
give me
back
my only
weapon. Take this gun. Escort this gentleman from the castle. If he resists, kill him.
Yes, Baron. Lieutenant.
We killed the baby, too. But it wouldn't have been his baby if he was gone for 2 years fighting.
Exactly. He was gone for a year fighting, remember?
My love. My love.
I am here.
I'm weary. My soul.
Let it go, the chain would be in the opposite direction.
Where's the bell?
tomb. He's locked himself in the crypt.
Eric is avenged.
Eric avenged? She used the girl as a puppet to drive the Baron to suicide. But why? She thinks it was the Baron that killed her son. She never knew it was you.
What do you mean? He killed my Eric.
Eric is her son?
You murderer!
Oh, wait! Don't you see now it was all a lie? The Baron did return that night to find Eric with the Baroness, and he did kill him. But there was a struggle, and in the fight, it was not Eric who died, but the Baron. I killed the Baron.
And Eric is still alive?
He took the Baron's place, and for 20 years, no one has known. He took the Baron's place in mind as well as body. In his mind, he is the Baron von Lepp.
Great. He's told him to flood the cellars. Now they'll both be killed. Hurry.
Flood the cellars? How? There's a tunnel that leads from the sea to the crypt. Come with me.
Yeah, I'm still not getting that. That's clearly, like...
Lock it from the inside.
Maybe she recognizes her own son.
You keep on here, I'll try and get in through the chapel.
Now, by giving your immortal soul to them, I will be free. Eric.
think the girl isn't actually a ghost. The girl was like somebody who was controlled
to
them.
It's over. Do you understand? You're free now.
Or maybe she's a ghost.
Free?